very, very quiet.
There is a corrugated gizmo underfoot. Oh, bless him. He is oh so cuddly again today. He really is. I said I would update on my my thing that was going to be a bad thing, but isn't a bad thing. So I'm happy. So I'm getting another three Reiki attunements. Which I know, I mean, Reiki's about healing. It's what I do, it's what I'm gonna do, it's what I've been doing. It's what I've been doing, but I nearly got into a row. Not like you, Mikey. Well, she was wrong. It's one of those things where you have a divide within certain disciplines on what's right and what's not. But as of last night, I thought she was implying that I would have to do another whole two, another whole course, aside from the one I'm doing. And she was saying it's not traditional Usui Reiki. And I was thinking, that is not what the other course said, the one that I have sent you as my evidence. So you are now contradicting the very people you work for. That's what it looked like. But, you know, in the sort of the master teacher's course I'm doing, it says, right, here's all the information, and now you make up your own mind and work accordingly. So it was that. And the other thing is, I mean, my other attunements, you know, the point was that Angel Reiki says it is Reiki and Reiki says it isn't. And Reiki was like, well, you were here first. Pretty much. I mean, that's a very crude way of looking at it, because a lot of Angel Reiki will say, yeah, but we've got the same lineage. We're attuned by the Sui lineage. It gets all like that. I don't like all that crap when people talk about lineages and authenticity, and this is the real one, and they're doing the same thing. So I just try to stay out of it. But I was ready to contact them, and I was going to say, right, here is a message from one of your practitioners. Here is your course materials. Explain this. Explain why you've had me registered on the World Energy Therapies Council for the last 2 years as a practitioner. Why have I received, what the is going on? But I don't have to do another course. I'm not doing another course. I just told her that. I just like replied. And so I just, there are other Reiki attuners. There are other Reiki masters. I will go to someone else who understands what the hell's going on here. But the good thing is, you know, there's always good to have another attunement. There's no reason why you can't have another attunement. Never. And the point was, the master attunement that I had before, I was like, but no one's taught me how to attune people. How can I be a Reiki master? I never felt like one, even though I was supposedly attuned to level 3. So now this lady will actually give me a certificate of her lineage, so I'll be able to provide one. So I'm gonna have both. Typical me, I will have both. I will be double fucking triple attuned to Reiki. But so that I've paid for. And I'm waiting to hear her to arrange when we're going to do it. I've got a call coming through. Hopefully it doesn't interrupt this call, actually. If he's prompt, it will. Because I did just look at the clock. But that's about the radio. We'll be getting my ID logins and what's it called? What are they called? Admin. I'm going to be admin. Do I get a badge? I'll be admin, actually. No, sorry, I'm admin. Excuse me, let me in, admin. Don't worry, not a problem. I'm admin. Hi, mate, what's your name? Admin. What's your name? Add me on Facebook. Yes, I'm going to be admin. So I'm waiting for that to come through. He is so cuddly. I've not been able to make the bed because he's like, don't go. Look, I'm deployed for office deploy. Where are we? Can I see what you're seeing? Oh, do I have to hold it up there? Yeah, there we go. Look, there's my chair, my salt lamp, my computer with its screensaver ready to go. I've got my glasses nose. Glasses ready. I've got my stationery. I've got my little stationery holder there. Have X stationery inside it. I feel like a businessman. But seriously, mate, this, that is my style when I'm living in my magic house. it's going to be something similar to that, but bigger. But I'm going to run a business from it. I'm going to do Reiki treatments from it. I'm going to record music, and I'm going to make techno, and I'm going to watch telly. I'm going to have multi-dynamical furniture. So it's in office mode. I'm ready to go. I haven't trained yet. I've had bagels. Had breakfast this morning. I've had bagels since, and I've got, oh yeah, this is. Oh. Chili tea. That's good shit. That is really, that wakes you up. Hello, Starrington. It's like. But I also wanted to talk about my friend. So, like, because I was going to mention this last night, but it was just lovely the way it all kind of turned out and how I just don't realize sometimes. So, I'd written something. I'd shared a post, a meme, and then she'd commented on it. And just said, I don't agree or something. I'd just been really properly a numpty. Blah, blah. I just was being a piss-taking twat. And I saw her message the next day, and I just, it didn't seem to calculate. And it none of it made sense. And she was like, yeah, the same as if my fella calls, I'll knock him into next week. And you have to remember, I get confused easily. I was thinking, you do? The thing is, I was really upset. I was really upset because it was again that thing you pissed someone off thing. But I was like, no, not her. She's really supportive of this. She's been really supportive of me doing this. And, you know, we're predominantly Facebook friends because she's miles away. So it's like I'd happily go somewhere and spend a day with her. If she was going out with her fella somewhere, I'd meet up with her on that. I'm that confident in my friendship with her that I'd be like, oh, you going? I'll see you there if we were going to a same event or something. But the fact is, she's like 6 hours away. So that's like, that's why our friendship's Facebook. But she's really supportive of this sort of stuff. But then what I did with it was I just kind of said, I don't even know if you're joking right now. I just answered back with a load of, I don't even know what. I can't even fucking remember. I was fucking confused. I was confused because I was totally thinking, you get confused? How the fuck am I supposed to think about that? It's a fucking meme, and you're talking about knocking someone into next week, and what the fuck? And like, yeah, it just probably made her laugh. That's it, she did. She put a laughing, like, thingy back to it because she was just thinking that I was just losing it. Like, just in a kind of comedy way, I think. But then I just sort of, I got a little bit more serious, and I just thought, I don't care if I'm making myself look a twat. I was like, sorry, but sometimes I get like that. I really didn't know if you were joking, and sometimes I will just get weird and ask for fucking stupid reassurances that don't seem like I need them. I was so fucking happy to see you were smiling. And she just put, what was it? It was really simple, but it said so much. And this is what's exciting about it. Was she put, no worries, no worries, buddy, everything is fine. As in between me and you, everything's fine. I know that's what she meant. We're not having a row, everything's cool. Don't worry. And she wasn't saying don't worry as in it's not there. And I just said that was an absolutely perfectical response. And the no response to that was, I know it was. I don't know what she meant by that. I know what she meant by that. That it was, she knew what I was going through. She was saying, mate, I hear you. I know that sometimes you're going to look a dick and you're going to say things that make you look a dick, but it's actually fucking real. And all you need, literally all you need is a little, seriously, everything's absolutely fine. Between us, there's not a problem. I'm telling you, there's not a problem. If I've said anything, you know, you can go on and say, if I've said anything that made it sound that way, I'm sorry, but blah, 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 blah. But sometimes it's that simple reassurance. And oh my God, sometimes that is like, just the fact that you've become unsettled or paranoid or whatever is enough to get offend the other person. Because they now think that you are casting aspersions upon their quality of friendship. And they're really not fucking happy about that, thank you very much. There's some sort of accusation going on there. And they now feel fully fucking justified in digging you the fuck out about it. Which has been a lot of my experience. So by saying that, that's what she was kind of saying. It was like, mate, I hear you. I know it was the perfect thing to say because I go through it too. That's what she meant. That's how I knew it was the perfect thing to say. I knew what you needed. And go me if I haven't just read between the lines, haven't I? I've just read between the lines on something. Now I really want a badge. Now I really want a badge that says reads between the lines and is admin. Actually. Fucking admin, But no, I wanted to like, I don't know if I'm allowed to say your name on here. Hi. She watches a lot of these. Just, well, I don't know how many she watches, but I know that she, there's a few people on Facebook that comment when I share these on Facebook. Very not often, probably about 1 out of 20, 1 out of 15, something like that, that actually gets. I mean, I'm not saying people don't watch it, but very often people don't comment on the actual shares. But a lot of people have. Having said that, a lot of different people have, you know, once or twice here and there. Absolutely. But it's just, you know, it doesn't really need to be commented on. It's like, I suppose the people that do watch it will think, well, I don't need to comment if I'm going to go and watch the video. But she's commented on quite a few of them, and she's put little love hearts on them. And a lot of people have done that, so just a little love heart to say, like, I've watched that and I feel for you. That's how I take it anyway. But she's been probably the most common one out of all of my friends to do that, and has been very, 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 very fucking supportive of this. And thank you. Mwah. Cheers, mate. Seriously, it keeps me going. Shit like that. You know, all of the people that have said, just, you know, hearing you identify this shit and give me something to relate to and all of that. That's fucking gold to know that I'm touching people in that way. That needs to fucking continue, no matter how much of a dick I am or what shit I put up on it, if it's helping people. But I do need those little bits of affirmation here and there, and she definitely does that. So that's why I was really worried, thinking, I'm falling out with someone like her when she's on my wavelength with a lot of this shit. She knows what's going on. You know, we all have our own individual picture of these types of issues, and you know, she's that's her business. I won't say what she has because I'm being anonymous. But she understands totally, and you know, she goes through, we all go through our own stuff, she goes through her own stuff. So I really didn't want to piss someone like that off. And also there's that button. See, even the people that under fucking stand, you push away from you. Even them you turn on. Even them you're fucking horrible to. What's wrong with you? You repugnant disgustoid. So I'm not feeling like a repugnant disgustoid. I've got other things. Oh, I've got to phone, totally forgot about telling you all about that. I've got to phone Dr. Fixity today. The email's come back about that. It's all go. I've got appointments galore. I need to have my admin call soon, so I'm going to have to leave you to it and do some very important adminery. And then do some Reiki and then do some arranging, and then I've got my charity stuff to do, and then I've got a phone call about that. I need to train. It's a very busy day in the world of Mikey, really. From suddenly nowhere. Giz, this is a that good boy. That was a really poor choice of seat. He literally had his back paws kind of on the edge of the mattress, and a fair old slump of his back weight hanging off the bed, and his front paws at a mild angle. It's like, that's not gonna end well, Giz. You're gonna roll over, mate. And there's gonna be no more there. There's gonna be no more there left. There will have moved down to there. So anyway, yeah, 30, 33. Yee.